On a sponsorship, right, which people typically tend to lose, is what is the objective that you're trying to solve for? Is it a launch that you're looking at, or is it product awareness? Is it usage, or is it to build frequency? Basically, these objectives, you decide whether you go ahead with the sponsorship or not. And more importantly, does it fit into the target audience you're trying to cater to? Does it fit into the passion points the target audience you need to follow? And the basis, there are other ancillary questions which you ask yourself before you take a decision. So, you know, for point in case, is there a way that you can seamlessly integrate the product or service into the sponsorship or the experience of the sponsorship, right? Are there leverages which the brand can take for engagement with the consumers, not only at the sponsorship, but also outside the ecosystem of the sponsorship? More importantly, does it seamlessly fit into your overall narrative of what you are trying to create for the brand? So, yeah, I mean, I would look at all these factors before deciding whether to pick up a sponsorship or not. This is a very interesting quote by the Center of Post-Normal and Future Studies. And it said that it's just not that the things are changing, but the very nature of the change itself is changing. So from that perspective, yes, virtual events will continue. There will be a market for virtual events. Like experience, it's also an opportunity for brands, like for many brands in many categories. It's an additional opportunity, if I may say so. I would also like to think this point is, I feel, this is my personal opinion, that virtual experiences will get better with time, okay? But there will be the entire sensory codes and how do consumer respond to the sensory codes is something which will be integrated in the experience itself. How do you contextualize the entire content of the experience so that the consumers are attracted towards it and also experience in that context itself. How do you anticipate much in advance is what will be the key differentiator for the event curators or the experience curators, if I may say so. And media will play a very important role in my view in coming years. Now, typically, when you look at media today, we look at media from a point of view of communication, right? But I'm not looking at media from that perspective. I'm saying that as we progress over a period of a few years, you'll see immersive media taking center stage. Virtual reality, augmented reality, mixed reality in retail is already happening in some cases. It will definitely change the way and the nature in which the virtual experience will happen and take forward in the future. So yes, in short, virtual experience is good. The agencies can bring to the table today is if they're able to stitch the messaging or the idea across the customer touch point or across the consumer journey. From the time the consumer decides or intends to buy a product or service to the purchase itself and post-purchase, if the agency can map all the touch points and see the relevant brand interventions across these touch points, that is when the real impact happens. And when I say real impact, that is when the organic impact happens. Honestly, in my experience, I've seen it also helps in a lot of cost efficiencies from an investment perspective and also from a resource perspective. So I think the agencies today are well equipped to do that. We've seen some really good campaigns across categories which is happening. It's just a holistic approach of looking at and mapping things well in advance rather than taking bits and pieces and then trying to stitch it together over a period of the campaign. So yeah. That was very, very relevant and every one of us can relate and resonate with it, which is called revenge buying. So we're all hoping for the post-normal to come soon. Yes, the live experience is here to stay. It will come back. It will be much better. It will be more impactful. I'm sure the curators have already thought of 10 different ways to make it much more experiential than what it is today. I think live events is going to continue for sure.